The cost of climate change in this country alone could reach the hundreds of billions of dollars. That according to a new U.S. government report released by the White House. It says climate change could devastate our economy and worsen our health. Andy Rose has more.
A dire warning from the U.S. Global Change Research Program.
This analysis, written by over 300 scientists, is going to only contribute to the overwhelming evidence that global warming is happening. It is human caused.
The report, released by the White House, directly contradicts the president's own words.
Does seeing this devastation, though, change your opinion at all on climate change, Mr. President?
No. I have a strong opinion. I want great climate. We're going to have that, and we're going to have forests that are very safe.
The governor of fire-ravaged California, however, agrees more needs to be done.
But managing all the forests in every way we can does not stop climate change. And those who deny that are definitely contributing to the tragedies.
According to the report, rising sea levels and storm surges threaten $1 trillion worth of real estate. Farmers will lose crops to droughts in some places and flooding in others. Experts are also expecting worse allergies and an increase in tick-borne and food-borne diseases in the coming decades. While the report makes no specific recommendations on how to fix the problems, it does make clear the cause.
As we start to see our global greenhouse gases, the heat-trapping gases in the atmosphere increase from transportation, electricity, industry, and agriculture, we are starting to see that direct link with extreme weather events.
I'm Andy Rose reporting.
Meanwhile, researchers from the East-West Center here say we're already seeing the impacts of climate change in the islands, from rising sea levels to temperatures, coral bleaching and other changes in rainfall patterns. A perfect example of climate change. We see it all the time right there in Mapunapuna.
All you have to do is go down Mapunapuna on a high tide day and you can see the roads already flooding. So they call that sunny day flooding. It's not raining, but there's ocean water and fish in the street. They really have to start looking at this as something that's impacting them now, can impact their families, where they live, and just the way that they live their lives, and this is something that we can respond to.
She says there are some impacts we cannot reverse, but we could all do our small part to slow things down, like driving our vehicles less and educating ourselves about what's happening around us.